characteristic properties of matter. First one, particles of matter have a space between them. How can we confirm it that they have a space? What here you have seen that when you put the matter, the volume has increased. Now we have to break this particle into smaller size to confirm whether they occupy space or not. For that one, I'm taking here a test tube. I'm taking a test tube and to that one I'm adding water. When I add water to this one, let me mark its label. I'm marking the label of water I have taken. This is the marking of the water label here I have taken. And now to this one, I'm going to add salt. This is the salt I have taken. Now when I'm adding it, the salt in it, this one, as we have confirmed it earlier with the previous experiment that the volume has increased, but here we'll not find any change in the volume. See, the volume has not changed. Where the particles of salts have gone? Actually, particles of salt are occupying the space between the water molecule. This demonstration confirms that there is a space between the particles of matter. Going for the next one, the particles of matter are always in random motion. How can you confirm it? I am taking a beaker which contains some water in it and going to add few drops of blue. When we add some few drops of blue in it, now see here, slowly this blue is going to get added and get dispersed throughout the liquid. Why it is getting slowly dispersed in the liquid? Reason is the particles of this blue I have added as well as water all are in motion. Because of their motion, they will get mixed up thoroughly after some time. After maybe 2 or 3 minutes, you will find that whole of the water will turn blue in color. This confirms that particles of matter are always in motion. We call this energy as kinetic energy, which depends on the temperature. If the temperature is high, the mixing will be faster. Next one, particles of matter attract each other. Now, this force of attraction which is there between the particles of matter, we call that one. If the matter is same, if the particles are same, suppose I have taken here water, now I'm going to pour it out. Still, you can see here that some droplets of water you can see it's lying. Why they were not being able to be poured out? Because there is a force of attraction between the glass as well as water molecule. Similarly, there when I am pouring the water is coming down, falling down, you can see that because of the force of attraction between the same particle of matter, that force is called cohesive force. And the force of attraction between water and glass is called adhesive force. Going for the next point for discussion, states of matter. Now, interparticular space, interparticular force of attraction and the motion, they decide the state of matter. We are going to discuss about three states of matter here, solid, liquid and gases. You can see with the pictorial diagram some differences here are available. In case of solid, the interparticular force of attraction is very strong, space is almost negligible and the kinetic energy with the particle motion is almost nil, only they can vibrate or they can spin at their mean position. Whereas in the case of, because of that one, what you find that they have a definite volume and they are incompressible and rigid shape and definite shape. Where in the case of liquid, this force of attraction is less. Why? Because there is intermolecular space available. They can flow. They have a fixed volume, but they do not have a fixed shape. Kinetic energy is more than that of the solid. In case of gases, particles are in a very high motion. The space between them is abruptly enlarged. And almost negligible force of attraction is available between the particles of matter. That's why, as there is huge space, they can be compressed. They can be compressed easily because of huge space. And if we lower the temperature, their kinetic energy becomes less and they may be converted to other states also. Going for the next one, interconversion of states of matter. There are two ways by which we can do it, by changing the temperature. Why? Because we know that by changing temperature, their kinetic energy can be reduced. If their energy is reduced, easily you will find that they will not move away faster and by the force of attraction they will come together and they will be converted to the state of lower energy. This can also be done by applying pressure. We have seen in the case of LPG. If the filled gas cylinder is there, you just shake it, you will find that as if water is available there. Now, this experiment demonstrates that ice can be melted to water, which is liquid in state condition, and water can be evaporized in the vapor by heating that in. Similarly, on cooling, reverse process can occur, which is a good example in the case of water cycle in the nature. Solid can directly change to gaseous state also. The process is called sublimation, as we can see in the case of camphor, as well as naphthalene balls. Similarly, gases can be changed to solid in the case, the process is called deposition, as we can see in the dry ice. Melting is the process of conversion of solid to liquid, evaporation from liquid to gas. Again, gas to liquid is called condensation, and liquid to solid is called your solidification. They occur at a fixed temperature, and that's called melting point, boiling point, condensation point, and freezing point. This is the all discussion today we have taken. Now, some assignment for you. First, write your observation and conclusions. We have done three experiments here. Next one, compare the three states of matter on the basis of the above experiments or the parameters we have discussed.